gosh, that hurt my back.
Oh, I'm just looking over my notes for this video before I start. Honestly, I had a whole nother video planned out, and as I was writing the notes, I just got a message from Spencer saying he's excited for my video, so man, if you're watching, thank you. Anyways, I had a whole nother video planned out, and I was writing the notes today for it, I just got discouraged about it, couldn't really figure out what I wanted to do with it, so I totally threw that away and I started to write notes for this video. I really hope you guys just like it, seriously. Anyways. What's up, guys? Anyways, today I'm going to be talking about a one location engagement photo shoot challenge. This was super fun. I just shot this like 2 days ago, these photos, and I'm really excited to share them with you and what went through my mind shooting them and kind of the whole layout with them. Now, I know you haven't seen the photos, so I'll be showing them, of course, throughout this video. And also, if you haven't subscribed yet, guys, please do. I'm trying so hard to get to 200 subscribers, and that would mean the world to me. I think it was like last year at this time I made it to 100 subscribers. I even made a whole video about it, a whole thank you video. If you haven't seen that, go check that out. Anyways, I'm trying to get to 200, so please, let's try to get there. If you like this video, please like it, comment, anything. Let's get to it. So I don't typically get asked, actually I probably never get asked to do photo shoots anymore just because I mainly just do video. Doesn't mean I don't like doing photos. I really do like doing photos still. It's just, I feel like I'm way better at video compared to photos. I struggle with photos maybe sometimes. But anyways, Alex and Bailey, they asked me to do this engagement photo shoot. Here's a picture of them from the shoot. And whenever they asked me, I just really couldn't turn it down. I just love taking their photos. I've done it before for them and they're super fun. So I decided to do it. So whenever they contacted me, they described a little bit about what they wanted and we went back and forth with that. This wasn't a official engagement photo shoot session. This was just something they wanted to release to the world to announce that they're engaged. So they said something about like 8 to 10 photos, and I thought that was perfect. I can do that totally. And literally the next day we went and shot these, and they just really wanted something pretty light and airy, I know, with some really good lighting. And you know, in the middle of the winter, that can be a really big challenge. Everything is dead. Everything is dark, there's no sun hardly ever, and a lot of the times it's either raining or snowing. So my first instinct was to, you know, we're gonna do the shoot outside somewhere during the sunset or that sunset lighting. That was my first instinct, and you know, I thought of where's a good scene outside that we can do this in. And I thought of a few places, but I got to thinking that I don't know if it's gonna look the way I want it to, just because, you know, everything's dead and kind of ugly and dreary in the winter. That's a hard word to say, dreary. Maybe it's just hard for me. Anyways, it's also really cold and just uncomfortable outside. And then I started to think if there's anywhere we can do an inside shoot at. But I don't know if it's just me. I just can't figure out anywhere to shoot inside. I never shoot photos inside because I always like the outside lighting. So I was really trying to think of places we could shoot inside. And I was thinking of like coffee shops or anywhere that has a lot of light coming in the front windows. And I was thinking, you know, there's gonna be people around. I don't wanna do that. I don't wanna be around people when I'm trying to do this. And I really don't want it to be in a store or restaurant area. And I just couldn't think of anywhere. So I decided to do it in my apartment. The location was in my apartment, and my first idea was to do it in this little spare room. As you can see in this area, I talked about this room a lot, but I thought about like this big window, get some light in there. You know, it's a little room, there's no furniture in this room. It would be really easy and really nice to do. But then I started looking around, my trim is brown, and my windows are, or not my windows, my walls are like green, and those colors definitely did not fit what I wanted and what I envisioned, and I don't think they would have liked that either. Those colors just aren't good for like an engagement shoot. Anyways, so then I moved on to the window in my living room. It's the same size, but it is white and it has a nice little curtain on it, and the walls around it are gray. It's all light, and I thought this spot would be perfect. Anyways, here it is right here. I had to move this recliner thing and this little pillow and the light. I just had to move everything out of the way in this area to really open it up. And so this could be our little area, our little one location for the photo shoot. Now, so I picked this because it was inside. It has great lighting right here. I thought the window would be a cool little backdrop thing area. Now to the fun part, the actual shoot. Real quick, some camera equipment, gear stuff. I used my 35 millimeter lens. All these photos were shot at f1.4, the lowest aperture, so I can get that nice, juicy, creamy, blurred out background. I usually always shoot at f1.4 for photos, and that's what I did for here. So one thing I thought about walking into this was, how am I going to get different poses, different angles with just one location? That was the biggest struggle I think I found. And I started thinking, and luckily it wasn't just a couple shoot, it was an engagement shoot. So what that means is there's a ring involved. So of course I started with some close-ups of just the ring. I had them hold hands, do different hand poses that just showcased the ring and the hands. So it didn't really matter about the face too much yet, or about their bodies, or really exactly where we were. And I just had to get good lighting on their hands to start off with. Also, starting off with the ring makes them more comfortable, because I start taking photos and it's not of their face. It just gets them more comfortable, more loose as the shoot goes on. So we started off with those. So then I actually had to get photos of them together as a couple, with also showing off their ring at the same time. So I had them stand in a few poses. I just had them do a few different things. It was really cool. I don't really like to have the couples look into the camera unless it's a certain, like a specific pose, trying to be more creative and artsy, like this one, like an engagement shoot I did a while ago. They're just looking right into the camera. It's a little different of a pose. It's more just artsy and fun, but I didn't do that for this shoot. I just had them, I like having them look down at the ground or look at each other and stuff like that. Very natural poses. I really don't tell them what to do. I tell them the pose, but as they're doing the pose, I just tell them to do whatever feels natural with that. Cause they'll ask me like, oh, where do I put my head? Or where do I look? Or where do I put my hand? I'm like, just do the pose and whatever feels natural. And I just try to get the most natural look out of it. So yeah, in all, but the poses, close-ups, far away of the ring, close-ups, far away of them. I also had them sit on this window ledge. I thought this was a brilliant idea. So I had them sit there, and these were some of my favorite photos with them just sitting in this window. The light behind them, or the background behind them, is exposed. You can kind of see out the window and you can see them. So I thought that turned out really well. Now, what are some struggles I came up along the way with this? There was a couple, specifically one. The lighting is coming in kind of the wrong way. Shooting in the window, you're shooting at the light, so they're being backlit, which is a struggle. That's how you get a silhouette effect, and that's not what I wanted. I wanted the window and them exposed. That's kind of hard. So when I was shooting close-ups of the ring, I couldn't shoot at the window because the ring would be very dark because it's not even facing the light. So I had to pose them. I'd like twist them into the window, and I was like standing in the windowsill taking the photos. And another struggle with that was, since I was shooting away from the window with the light coming in, I was shooting that way, stuff in the background started to show. So I really couldn't show my couch or my TV or anything like that, because that's totally not something you want in your engagement photos. So I had to really like crop in and angle myself in a way you didn't really see that. That was pretty hard. Luckily, it was really blurred out, and I was pretty close to them. So those were the two really hard things to come up that I had to avoid, was, you know, the lighting situation, how, and things in the background showing up. I also did a few photos in my window in the kitchen, just to really change things up and just get a different look. First, for a few more photos, and these ones turned out nice. I just had them stand there and be cute together. They're super cute. And also, I thought the brick in the window looked really cool. That's just the building next to me. So yeah, this shoot took about 20 minutes really, just in my apartment. It was super quick. I edited them in like the next hour. So it was just a really quick turnaround shoot, and it was really a challenge. I thought it'd be really fun for a challenge to do one location for these photos. And I probably got about 20 photos out of it, actually, even though they only wanted about 8 or 10. And yeah, the natural lighting really is key here. I can't stress this enough. I know I mentioned this in a lot of my videos about video and photo, is how important natural lighting is and how well it looks. And that's really what I was using and amplifying in this photo shoot is the natural light through these massive windows. Thanks for watching. I don't really know what to think of this video. I don't know how long it'll be, but I did this photo shoot like 2 days ago and it was really fun, and I thought I'd share it because it's just a little bit unique. It had a little bit of a twist to it, and it worked out really, really well, I think. I added these in Lightroom. I have a couple presets that I use. They're nothing special. It's just, I try to get a really natural look out of my photos so it doesn't look extremely edited or anything. And I think it worked really well in this situation. Now, thank you guys so much for watching. My next video is going to be Friday, so please stay on the lookout for that. If you enjoyed this video, please like, please comment anything. Literally, you can comment anything and I respond to all my comments on here. Yeah, like I said in the beginning of the video, I'm trying to get to 200 subscribers, so please, if I can get to there, that'd be awesome. I'm so thankful for every single one of you guys that subscribe. I seriously see all of you guys that do, and I really do appreciate it. I can't emphasize that enough. So anyways, my next video is Friday. Stay on the lookout for that.